Dear students, continuing with organic reaction mechanism, this is our 42nd lecture on organic reaction mechanism, and we have already discussed some lectures on aromatic lactophilic substitution reactions. And in lactophilic aromatic substitution reactions, we have discussed the general mechanism of lactophilic aromatic substitution reactions. In addition, we have also studied nitration, sulfonation, halogenation, and Friedel-Crafts alkylation and acylation reaction under different lectures. So details of their applications have also been studied in different lectures. And one more important aspect in this regard is the orientation and reactivity of different types of aromatic systems. And we will discuss these orientation and reactivity of monosubstituted as well as disubstituted benzenes. So when it comes to the case of monosubstituted benzene ring, this say for example in case of nitrobenzene, if nitration is done, then nitration can take place either at ortho position or at meta position or at para position. So depending upon the type of group which is present as a substituent at this place, the rate of the reaction will be determined, as well as that how much of the ortho product is formed, how much of the meta product is formed, and how much of the para product is formed. This will also be determined by the type of substituent which is present on the benzene ring. So basically means that the group which is already present on the aromatic ring will determine the position of the new group which will enter as an electrophile. And further, it will also determine that whether this reaction will be slower reaction or faster reaction in comparison to unsubstituted aromatic ring, that is benzene. So any group which increases the reaction rate with respect to benzene, these are called as activating groups. And any group which slows down the rate of electrophilic aromatic substitution is called as deactivating group. And out of all these activating or deactivating groups, some groups they will be predominantly meta-reacting. Meta-reacting means the major product formed in such cases will be a meta product. And it has been found that most of the meta-reacting groups, they are deactivating in nature. Why they are deactivating, we will explain in the forthcoming slides. Then some groups, they are ortho-para-reacting. That means the products formed are predominantly ortho or para products. And out of all these ortho-para-reacting groups, some of these are deactivating, but most of them they are activating in nature. So for example, if we take the case of nitrobenzene, and if it undergoes nitration, it has been found that the 93% of the product formed is metadinitrobenzene, 6% of the product formed is orthodinitrobenzene, and 1% of the product formed is paradinitrobenzene. So on the basis of this, we can say that if the substituent present on the benzene ring is nitro, then nitro is a meta-directing group. So it will direct the electrophile to get attached to the meta position. Sorry. And overall, the rate of the reaction is slower in comparison to benzene itself, because the nitro group is a deactivating group. Why this is deactivating, I will explain in the coming slides. Now, for example, we will see that what type of resonating structures they are possible as per the mechanism, that if the group is attached to ortho position or meta position or para position. Now we know when electrophile, this Z is the any substituent group which is present on the benzene ring, and this Z any group may be an electron releasing group or electron withdrawing group. So when the electrophile, say Y, gets attached to the aromatic ring, then these types of intermediates, they will be formed. These types of resonating structures will be formed if the electrophile, that is Y, gets attached at the ortho position or meta position or para position. And you can see, we say that more the number of resonating structure, higher will be the stability of the ion formed in the electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction. Now, on the basis of these resonating structures, we can tell whether a group is ortho directing or para directing or meta directing. Now, for example, if you see this structure and this structure, now in this case, if this Z is electron releasing group, then this electron releasing group will decrease the positive charge at this place. So when the charge is neutralized due to electron releasing effect of this group, that means the stability of this will be more in case of ortho, and in case of para, this should not have been colored, this should have been colored. The same thing, when this positive charge is present at this place, this Z group which is electron releasing will neutralize this positive charge, and stability of this structure will be more in comparison to this structure. And this is in case of para, this is in case of ortho. And if you see the structures in case of meta positions, you will see that there is no structure where the positive charge is present at this carbon, which is close to electron releasing group. That means all these three positions, ortho, meta and para, they have same number of resonating structures. But in case of ortho and para, one of the structure is of higher stability, because this leads to stabilization of this positive charge present on the aromatic ring. And because of this higher stability of these two structures, the electron donating groups, they will stabilize these ions more in comparison to when the electrophile gets attached to the meta position. So that means the electron releasing groups, they will be ortho para directing groups. Similarly, if this Z group is an electron withdrawing group, this is having minus inductive, minus I effect. So when this is electron withdrawing, that means this will increase, this will decrease the electron density at this place, and this will destabilize this positively charged ion. Similarly, here also, this, because of the electron withdrawing capacity of this group, this will withdraw electron density, and this will destabilize this ion. So these two destabilizing cations, they are present only in ortho and para position, whereas there is no destabilizing factor in case of meta position. So that is why the electron withdrawing groups, they will increase the positive charge on the ring here and here, and because of that, they will stabilize the rhenium ion. So all electron withdrawing groups, they will be meta directing in nature. So formation of a stabilized ion should be faster. So in case of electrolyzing groups, these are the stabilizing factors, so they will act as activating groups. So electrolyzing groups, they are activating in nature, whereas destabilized ions, they should be slower or deactivating. So electron withdrawing groups, they will be deactivating because of these two conditions where they will withdraw electron density from the positive charge. So such field effects, they are strongest at the carbon connected to the Z group. As I have already told you, this carbon is called as the ipso carbon to which this substituent is attached. So maximum effect of stabilization or destabilization takes place at this carbon, that is ipso carbon. So that is why either this structure or this structure will determine whether the Z group will activate or deactivate the ring, or this will be slower or faster depending upon the electron donating or electron withdrawing capacity of these groups. Then you can see over here same thing, the of the three arenium ions, only ortho and para have positive charge at the carbon. This and this, they have the positive charge on the carbon, and none of the canonical structures in case of meta, the positive charge is present on the ipso carbon, which I have already told you. Therefore, the substituent groups which are having plus I effect, that is plus inductive effect, they should stabilize the aromatic system. And all three ions, mostly ortho and para, should not only be the activating but ortho para directing. So this will also increase the rate of the reaction at ortho and para position, as well as they will be activating in nature. Whereas the groups with minus I effect, that is minus inductive effect, they will remove electron density from this ipso carbon, and they will be deactivating and meta directing only, because in case of meta, no positive charge is present at the ipso carbon. So on the basis of this, we can generalize that electron withdrawing groups, they are meta directing and deactivating, and electron leasing groups, they are ortho para directing and activating in nature. Now there are some substituents which have pair of electrons, unshared pair of electrons present, which can be contributor towards the ring. For example, in case of halogens, you can say that they can withdraw electron density also because of the electronegativity difference between carbon and the halogen. They can withdraw electron density, hence destabilize, but at the same time they have a unshared pair of electrons which can be shared with the aromatic ring. So an additional structure of this type is also possible in case of those substituents which are having an unshared pair of electrons. So we can see that such an additional structure is possible, which will stabilize this positive charge, because this ring will have complete octet of electrons and positive charge will be present outside the ring. So that means this will stabilize the overall, this will stabilize this system at ortho and para position, because such sharing of electrons of the unshared pair of electrons present on this substituent group is only possible in case of ortho and para. Such structure is not possible in case of meta meta incorporation of the electrophile. Therefore, such groups they will be orthopararecting, but because of the electron withdrawing nature, they will be destabilizing in nature. But these will activate the ortho and para position due to these things. Then another important aspect is when a group is orthopararecting, that in what ratio ortho and para products they will be formed. So it is very difficult to predict that which isomer, either ortho or para isomer, will be formed in how much amount. But there are some factors on the basis of which we can say on case to case basis that what type of ratio of ortho to para products will be formed. For example, in case of chlorination of toluene, if we see the ortho para ratio, this may vary between 62 to 38 to 34 to 66.47. So this is purely a statistical base, that there can be 67% ortho and 33% para, because there are two ortho position and only one para position. But there are cases where the opposite has happened, and this can only be determined on the case to case basis, because in case of for example phenonium ion, this one, if we compare the approximate charge distribution at ortho position, the charge distribution is 0.25, whereas at meta position it is 0.1 in each case, whereas in case of para position it is 0.3. So based on charge distribution, we can say that a para substituent would have a greater stabilizing effect on the adjacent carbon than an ortho substituent, because the charge distribution is more at the para position. And if other effects they are absent, this means that 33% of para and 67% of ortho substituent would be formed. But when these unsubstituent groups, they are replaced by some other groups, either electron leasing or electron withdrawing, then ratio of the ortho to para product formation changes. And another factor which is very important is the steric factor in determining whether more of ortho product will be formed or more of para product will be formed. So for example, in case of nitration, if we compare the case of toluene and tertiary butyl benzene, so only difference between toluene and tertiary butyl benzene is that in case of toluene, methyl group is the substituent, whereas in case of tertiary butyl benzene, it is tertiary butyl group, which is a sterically hindered group, is the substituent. When nitration is done, then it has been found that in case of toluene, we got 58% of the ortho product and 37% of the para product. But because of the bulky nature of tertiary butyl group, it has been found that only 16% of the ortho product is formed in case of tertiary butyl benzene, and 73% of the para product is formed. So this example shows that the type of substituent present will very much determine that how much of ortho product will be formed and how much of para product will be formed. And some groups, they are so large that they direct almost entirely para product is formed because of the steric hindrance. Then orientation and reactivity in case of benzene ring with more than one substituent, and we will see on the basis of some examples that on the basis of the type of substituents present, we can very much predict that what type of product will be formed. formed in such cases. For example, in case of 1,3-dimethylbenzene. So the next electrophile will be substituted at position 4. This position 4, which is because the both these groups, they are electron losing, that means they are ortho paradirectic. So this position is ortho with respect to this methyl and para with respect to this methyl. So that is why the next electrophile will enter at position 4 and not at position 5, which is meta to both these positions. So either this can act at 4 or equivalent position is 6 also. 6 is para with respect to this and ortho with respect to this. But if you attach methyl over, if you attach the third group over here, these are equivalent positions, either 4 or 6. Similarly, incoming group in case of parachlorobenzoic acid. So this is parachlorobenzoic acid, and this the third electrophile will add at this position, which is ortho to chloro, and which is meta to carboxylic acid, because carboxylic group is a meta directing group, whereas chloro group is an ortho para directing group, and para position is already occupied. That means this will, the electrophile will enter at this position or this position, because these two positions, they are equivalent, that is ortho to chloro and meta to carboxylic acid. Similarly, when we have groups which oppose each other, then predictions may be more difficult. And if we are having two different groups, but these groups, they have about equal directing ability in the competing position, then all four possible products, they can be expected. For example, in any two substituent, say here it is X, it is Y, and they are have almost all equal directing ability, then all four possible products, they will be formed. Similarly, for example, in this case, methoxy and N-acetyl group, they yield substitution ortho to acetamido group here instead of ortho to this methoxy, and mixture of equal proportion of products will be formed in such cases. Then even when groups on a ring, they oppose each other, there are some regular features which are shown by the aromatic system. For example, if a strong activating group competes with a weaker one or with a deactivating group, then the activating group will control that where the incoming electrophile will get attached. So if we are having this case of cresol, one is hydroxyl group and other is methyl. So here the product formed is mainly ortho and para with respect to hydroxyl group, not to methyl group, because this is more activating in comparison to methyl group because of the presence of lone pair of electrons on the oxygen. So we will have this ortho and para product formed in this case. And for this purpose, the order of activation for different groups is given here, that amino group is more activating than hydroxyl, then N,N-dialkyls, then oxygen, then ether, then esters, then amides, then alkyl aryls, then halogens, then meta directing group. So on the basis of this order, we can determine that which type of product will be formed in which case, on the case to case basis. Similarly, if all other things are equal, a third group is least likely to enter between two groups in the meta relationship. if there are two groups present in the meta, then this position is the least suitable for addition of an electrophile as a product. So this is mainly because of steric hindrance, which will not allow the electrophile to enter because of the presence at these two meta position. Then when a meta directing group is meta to an ortho para directing group, the incoming group primarily goes ortho to meta directing group rather than para. So for example, if we take the case of this one, in case of if we are doing chlorination of this meta nitrochlorobenzene, then these two products they will be formed because this will enter with respect to either para or ortho. Although if you see the previous slide, we have said that this type of product formation in between these two is not possible, but here this is an exception. Some product of some amount of this product is also formed, although this is the major product, and this effect is called as ortho effect. So this is in violation of the rules which we have said earlier, but whenever there is formation of such product, this effect is called as ortho effect, and here this product will not be formed where the group entering is ortho to this but para with respect to the meta directing group. So this product is not formed in this case. So another example of ortho effect is nitration of this para bromotoluene, and when nitration is done, then the major product formed is this one, which is ortho to this group as well as this group. So this is again an example of ortho effect, and this is possibly there is an intramolecular assistance for the meta directing group which is there in case of such type of examples where ortho effect is taking place. So these are the references from where this lecture has been prepared. Thank you very much.